In this video, I'm gonna share how I mount my camera for overhead cooking shots. I'll show you two different stands that I've used, and I'll break down all the little things that you'll need to mount your camera or phone to the stand. I'll also share a few different options at different price points so that you can pick something that fits more within your budget. At the end, I'll share 5 tips on how to capture better overhead footage. So the first and what I would consider the best stand to invest in is gonna be a C stand. The one that I'm using is about $160 and it's the newer C stand. It's heavy duty, it's super solid, and I feel confident that it'll hold my camera and lens without breaking or falling over. This entire stand breaks down if you needed to, and it includes collapsible legs, an extended stand, a grip arm, and a grip head. The stand goes up to about 10 feet and the arm extends out 4 feet. Not only is this thing great for overhead shots, but I also use it to hold things like my lights, or I can clamp a backdrop on the grip arm for photos, and it even holds my microphone overhead for things like interviews or YouTube videos. This thing is universal and you'll find them on every major movie set and studio, and that's why this is my first recommendation. The other light stand that I've tried is this $80 newer light stand with a boom arm. This thing is built all in one and it doesn't break down like the C stand. It can go up to 13 feet high though, and the boom arm extends out to 6 feet. What's unique about this is that it pivots on this access point that I don't really know what it's called, but this is the one thing that kind of worries me, because I've seen some people post that this part has broke on them. But I don't put a ton of weight on this, so I think you're probably okay using a small mirrorless camera or even your phone, and I think this thing is gonna be more than enough to hold those. It is a little more flimsy than a C stand, and I just don't like how that little pivot point thing works. The thing that I love about the C stand is the grip head has these little teeth that lock into each other, so you can easily fine tune the angle of the arm. The other downside of this thing is that the legs spread very far apart, and this might not be ideal if you're working in a small space. There are a bunch of other options out there that clamp or even sit on your workspace or counter, and the main and only reasons why I wouldn't recommend getting one of these is because if your table isn't like rock solid like mine, when you're cooking or prepping or doing something like chopping or mixing, it's gonna shake the table, and then that's eventually gonna shake your camera, and that's gonna create really shaky, unusable footage. Okay, so now that we've talked about the stands, I'm gonna talk about all of the little things that you'll need to mount your camera or your phone. I'll talk about all of the camera options first, and then we'll jump into the phones. And then after that, I'll share 5 tips to filming better overhead footage so that your shots are not shaky, framed nicely, and most importantly, in focus. So if you really wanted to, you could just screw your camera directly onto the grip arm or stand, but it does make it difficult to fine tune your framing. What I would recommend is getting a light stand mount that has an articulating ball head. This piece attaches to the bottom of your camera and then it clamps onto the light stand or grip arm. This now gives you the ability to easily adjust your camera once it's positioned up and over your prep or cooking area. The ball head that I have was only $12, but if you wanted to step it up a bit to the next level, I would recommend getting a mini ball tripod head. There's a bunch of options out there, but what makes these tripod heads great are that they include a quick release plate that attaches to the bottom of your camera. This makes it so much easier to quickly mount and remove your camera from the stand compared to having to unscrew it all the time. Another great feature with both of these articulating ball heads is that you have the ability to quickly switch from horizontal to vertical composition when shooting any sort of top-down video or photos without having to move your whole entire stand over to the side. When it comes to mounting your phone, all you need is this inexpensive phone holder. There's a bunch out there, but I like this one because it's all metal and it has a bunch of different mounting points so that you can easily screw it into a stand or add a quick release plate to the bottom so you can mount it on your tripod as well. It also has an articulating ball head built in, and that rotates 300 degrees so you can position your phone however you want it. If you made it this far in the video, I just want to say thanks so much. And you know, if you're like me and if you enjoy cooking and then filming it and then putting on the internet, I can show you how to make better looking and sounding cooking videos. Aside from all my cooking videos, I post a ton of how-to content just like this one. And if that sounds like something you're into, consider subscribing. And if you found value in this video and you wanted to support me as a content creator, consider signing up for my Patreon or becoming one of my YouTube members, Or if you wanted to, you can simply buy me a coffee. I'll have a link in the description below. So earlier I promised 5 tips, and you know, I actually got one bonus one at the very end. So we'll just jump into those right now. So tip number one is gonna be to position the legs of your stand and get it aligned with the arm that extends out. This is gonna help support the weight of the camera so that it doesn't fall over. If your arm is pointed between two legs, this is gonna make it very easy for your stand to fall over. I'd highly recommend investing in sandbags. These are super cheap and they ship empty so that you can just fill them with sand yourself once they get delivered. Tip number two is going to be to extend the arm out as little as possible. The closer that the arm is to the middle of the stand, the less it's gonna wanna tip. But not only that, it's less likely to shake when you're messing with your camera settings mid-shoot. You can also place another sandbag right in the middle to help with this as well. So tip number three is gonna be to use a zoom lens. A zoom lens is super helpful because you can easily crop the image to how you'd like it instead of having to go back and forth raising the stand up and down. Tip number four is to get a bubble level. This thing is super cheap and it pops onto the hot shoe of your camera. This is a great way to make sure that your camera is level and it's shooting straight down. This makes it so that all of your lines are straight and everything in your shot looks perfect. If you're on an iPhone, this is actually already built in. When you open your camera in photo mode and point it down, there's a white and yellow plus sign. Just line the two up and then your phone will be shooting straight down. Then switch it over to video and you're good to go. Tip number five is an important one, and it's to shoot in manual focus. When shooting top-down shots, your hands are always going to be in front or on top of whatever you're doing. Because of this, your camera's gonna wanna focus on your hands and not on the food. By switching to manual focus, you can easily adjust it to just focus on the food, and you don't have to worry about your hands throwing everything off. I dive deeper into how to do this in my course that I'm creating, and if you're interested in catching that, I have the details in the description of this video. So now you might be asking, well, how do I do manual focus with a phone? And that leads me into the bonus tip, which is that you can use a camera app that enables the ability to film with manual focus. The app that I would recommend is Filmic Pro. What's even doper about this app is that there's even a plugin that you can download that allows you to monitor and even control your phone from another device. And this is so sick because it's hard to see what you're doing when your camera is above your head shooting down. And with this app, now you can control and watch what's going on. And I'll have a whole nother video on how to do this and how it works. That's it for this one. I hope that you found this video helpful. Like, subscribe, and all that shit, and then I will catch you in the next one. Aloha.